Still in the news, the Minister of Health, Dr. Osagie Ehanire, on Thursday revealed that 113 health workers had been infected with COVID-19. Ehanire, who disclosed this at the press briefing of the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19 in Abuja, said they included workers in the public and private health facilities. He therefore reiterated his advice to health workers that it was dangerous to treat coronavirus patients without using personal protective equipment. The minister had at a task force media briefing in Abuja on April the 23rd said about 40 health workers in the country had tested positive for coronavirus. Ehanire, who lauded health workers for their commitment to the war against COVID-19, warned them against treating patients without the PPE. Joining us now is the NMA president, Francis Faduyile. Good morning, Mr. Faduyile.
Good morning. It's my pleasure. Happy Workers' Day.
Happy Workers' Day. It is really worrisome that health workers who are at the front line of COVID-19 are getting infected. How do you see this, and what's largely responsible?
Thank you very much. You observe that these are some of the things we have earlier enumerated that the government must put in place so that every health worker is protected. Where we have majority of this infection or this transmission is at the hospitals or health centers where patients are coming with different medical ailments. And there is no way you can know until a test is done for you to know that those patients are having COVID-19 positive. And COVID-19 infection, I mean. And we have said that all hospital outlets must have the personal protective equipment so that every health worker, wherever they are, must be properly kitted for them to see patients. What we have seen in the last few weeks is that the personal protective equipment are supplied majorly at the different treatment and isolation centers, leaving the other hospital outlets not having the proper gadgets. And this is very, very unfair on the health workers. And we are seeing a large number of health workers now coming down with COVID-19.
The outbreak of the COVID-19, there are reports suggesting doctors were leaving Nigeria for greener pastures abroad. Please clarify and maybe tell us why it is so.
The emigration of doctors and other health workers from Nigeria is something that we have been discussing severally. A majority of those who have left because of the working environment as well as the interest that government has put into health system generally in the country. We have said that the working environment is not good. We have had a lot of cases in which tools that doctors and other health workers needed are not in place in the different hospitals. We have seen a lot of the state government and federal government not creating the necessary spaces for the health workers to be employed and to perform their duties. We have seen so many consultants that are not employed or gainfully employed. We have seen so many nurses and other health workers that are not having their normal employment. We have seen some very, very difficult working environment. The office space, the number of patients that you have to see because you have not employed the number of health workers you needed to have. And to make things worse, the remuneration of the health workers had been abysmally low compared to other countries around Africa and outside this continent.
And this brings me to my next question. Sorry if I may interject you, Mr. Faduyile. That brings me to my next question, which is, You know, some days ago, the government says it was giving the insurance to medical workers, health practitioners, and also mentioned that 50% of their salaries would be added onto them as the hazard hazard reasons. Can you confirm if this has been provided for the health workers?
Well, we need to quickly state that this incentives is given only for federal government workers, not generally for all health workers. And majority of health workers are outside the federal government employment. But being that as it may, it is true that we have discussed and negotiated with the government that during this COVID-19 season, where a lot of health workers are exposed, that the federal government has seen it, that they needed to improve the hazard allowance and also give some form of inducement. So the 50% that we have seen covers both the hazard allowance and inducement during this time of COVID-19. We are appreciative of that. And the MOU came and the pronouncement came short some few days of towards the end of the month, and I doubt if any federal worker can get that reflected in their April salary. However, it is also important that in that MOU, we also emphasize that PPEs should be provided to all hospital outfits. And the medical insurance, I must tell you that the insurance that the government has promised to provide is still the insurance within the federal civil servants, the one that one gets through the Employee Compensation Act, and the other one that one gets through the National Social Insurance Trust Fund. The only addition is the one that we were told that some insurance firm has offered to give those who are working at the isolation and treatment centers of COVID-19 generally in the country.
All right, lastly, what are your expectations from the government on providing better welfare for health workers? Because it's a conversation that we will still continue to have.
Certainly, you had the Honorable Minister of Labor and Employment the last time who said that some of the money that are being paid, the wages, are not commensurate. And in our discussion, he agreed that for us to be able to retain our health workforce, we must be able to give a competitive or comparative wage in relationship with our fellow African countries as well as in the world generally. We must not forget that the world now is a global village where everybody can work anywhere within the world, and Nigeria must put on concerted effort to be able to retain its workforce within the country. It is not only in wages, it is also in the absolute employment of the adequate number of staff, as well as improving the working relationship, right. The working environment, I mean.
Thank you so very much, Francis Faduyile, and please do stay safe out there.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure.